In this episode, I invite you to participate in an experiment. I have not done this before, so I don't know what the results will be. They will either be magnificent or not. I was watching a gardening program. Don't ask me why. I don't have a garden. I don't like gardening, but I do like gardening programs. And there was a little segment about a French artist, Paola Bord, who creates handbags using natural materials. Like this one, and especially this one where she used rose petals. So she didn't go into her process, of course, in detail, so I will be guessing a lot of things, and I'm not making bags, but I saw that this might be a good idea, for example, for an album cover, a book cover. So let's try something. I had these leaves and some plants left from botanical prints I did, and I cut up a very ordinary cardboard box to create my base. And the only thing I measured was the size of the cardboard so that it fits in the die-cutting machine. So this was my die-cutting machine's plate, according to which I cut my cardboard. And if you look at these leaves, they do look a little bit like leather, right? Especially these big brown ones. They have even the leathery feel to them. So what the artist was doing, she was gluing fresh plants to her substrate, fresh rose petals, for example. And that really scared me. I was not sure how the fresh plants, you know, with moisture in them, how they will behave. So I decided to use dry leaves and dry plants, just to be on a safe side. As always, when I need to glue big surfaces, I started with liquid gel medium. But very quickly I understood that the liquid gel medium doesn't hold the heavy, thick leaves very well. And I've decided to switch to heavy gel medium. Gluing the leaves was not easy. Maybe next time I will tear them up in smaller pieces, because they are very unruly. You glue down one end of the leaf, the other end springs up. That's why I very quickly understood that I need some more serious glue for this. I will speed up a little bit this process. And I'm covering both sides of the leaf with the gel medium, thinking that it will also give me a waterproof surface to work on later. I'm choosing different colors and different sizes of leaves, but it isn't that important, as I intend to add some color later on my background. I am being much more generous with plants, as the artist was. She was just adding some scattered plants here and there. But since I don't know what she was gluing on or what she was using as a glue, I've decided to cover my cardboard totally with plants and see how it will play out. The glue is still not dry, but I have to cut the excess leaves off because I want to put this through the die-cutting machine and they will not fit. Otherwise, I wouldn't do that. I would let the leaves dry and then cut the excess. But now, despite making a mess and covering everything in glue, I had to cut the leaves. And then I decided to do another piece, but this time I'm using less material, less leaves. I just wanted to see if that makes a difference. So after gluing the plants to her substrate, the artist was pressing everything under the very serious printer's press, which I don't have, of course. But I have the next best thing, which is a die-cutting machine, so I will be using that. And since the glue is still wet, I figured that it needs to be wet, otherwise the pressing will not work. I had to think of how to protect my die-cutting machine and my plates. So I put the glue-covered leaves on the cutting plate, and this is acrylic plate, so I was not afraid of getting glue on it. I knew that I will be able to wash it. But before putting on the top plate, I covered everything in a plastic bag just to make sure that the glue, which will inevitably seep out, doesn't stick to anything. And then it took me some time, of course, to figure out the sandwich. So I played with the layers on the die-cutting machine's base to feel which amount is right to get the good pressure for the glued leaves to pass through the die-cutting machine. And here it is how it came out of the die-cutting machine. And this was a very nervous moment. I was not sure if I have glued everything together now. Will I be able to peel off the plastic? In theory, it should work. And luckily, it did work in practice also. There were little pieces that got stuck. I was not worried about them. And as you see, there is glue everywhere. And then I repeated the same process with the other piece of cardboard. And again, the unwrapping, the nervous moment of unwrapping. But this thought worked, although there are some pieces that are sticking to the plastic. It still works. Enough of the leaves are glued down and sticking down, and I'm just lifting off the things that didn't glue down. And the glue will still dry, so if there are some loose bits, I can glue them again and let them dry later. And it is really getting messy at this point. There is glue everywhere. There is glue on my wrapping plastic, glue on my hands. Obviously glue on the brush. And as you see, the bottom part of the cardboard is covered in glue. So I'm taking off the excess using my brush. Of course, the glue will dry transparent, so I'm not worried at all that it is visible. It is just very, very messy. Ugh. See, there is such... Although it didn't seem that I was putting on a lot of glue. Of course, when you put it through the press, a very, very thin layer of glue remains and everything else gets pressed out. See my hands? See my table? So I'll let this dry and wash my hands. And this is how they look when they are dry, and I'm loving it. Aren't they gorgeous, if I may say so myself? I prefer the one on the right to the one on the left. So that's the first one that I made, and I think there are too many things going on, perhaps. I prefer the second one, where I glued less plants, and especially this little corner where the dogwood plant is really impressed into the background leaves. I think that's my favorite part. See how it's really, really impressed into the leaves. And that made me think that maybe next time I need to use a softer background, a foam sheet maybe. That's a thought. But for now, I will continue working on this board. Although, as I said, I think it is perfectly okay as it is, even without any detail. But I added a little bit of shadows around the bigger leaves with an ink pencil and diluting the ink using just a tiny bit of water on my brush. Then I had to decide what to do next. I was thinking, if the artist is making bags, she needs to be covering her material with something waterproof. And you would really need something like a sailing boat varnish to make a bag waterproof. I don't have a sailing boat varnish because I don't have a sailing boat. So I decided to use just a spray, an ink spray, to give an even tone. And since I'm still a little bit in this, I like gold mood, I took the golden ink spray by Seth Apter. Gorgeous stuff. Now let's see how it behaves when I will put them on top of the leaves. Luckily, the gel medium allows me to put on top whatever I want, and it should work. And I think that the gold spray worked wonders. And the material is now united, and it literally looks something like you could make a bag out of, or a book cover. Gorgeous! I decided to add some more detail, and I took a black archival ink and a stamp. I wanted to add some text. I chose this one simply because it says some artful things like create, concept, imagination. It will not be very readable anyway, but I know that it's there, and I have to choose somehow a stamp out of 20-30 other text stamps. And while the ink is out, I'm going around the border. Even if I don't know what I'm going to make out of it, I wanted to have a little border so that this piece looks a little bit finished. And then I'm highlighting with the white acrylic marker just some of the plants, because the white border allows them to pop a little bit and creates sort of a foreground and background. And just to add some accent, I'm adding splashes with a turquoise acrylic paint and a little bit in the corner there. And this is it! What do we think? Was the experiment successful? I really like how this looks. I don't know if it's practical or not, but I do think that it has a potential of becoming a gorgeous book cover or album cover. Imagine if you put like metal label frame on it, some other details. I invite you to try this, and maybe there are other things we could glue down besides leaves.